Okay, one of my students asked me if I could show her how to make this kind of bottle. So today I'm going to do that. A little bit challenged because it's very flat, so it's easy to collapse from the shoulder. And also the base is small. And then you need to close the top smaller. So I'm going to show you how I approach to that. Okay, let's go. This piece of clay is around 4.5 pounds. To make something that is flat, use the clay a little bit stiffer help to support, especially the shoulder part. So when drilling it, I usually take it all the way until I got the right thickness. And then I start to widen it, widen the base. Then compress the base a couple times. Then I'm coloring in to make the cylinder a little bit narrower. So when I color in, there's a little indentation there. And then I just try to lift from the indentation. Since this piece is not that big, so I'm going to just grab like that and then lift it. And I'm using my right hand to support it. Basically, it's my left hand grabbing the clay. So this is my initial lifting. And make sure it is slippery. Alright, and then I'm going to change my position using my thumb to lift it. Bring the base corner, bring the bottom corner in so that this part is smaller. Since I'm making a narrow neck, so I'm keeping the rim a little bit smaller. So my last pulling is, I start to widen it a little bit when I'm lifting up. Now I'm ready to get rid of the throat mark. And also shaping a little bit. So change into my metal rib. Right, so I spend around 2 to 3 minutes to dry the surface a little bit so it will be stronger before I stretch it out further. So as you see that I leave enough clay here so I will be able to close it. So this is my position. The fingers inside to support it, and then this thumb is kind of lifting clay toward the center. Right, so this is the finished flat narrow neck bottle. And I use a torch to dry a little bit so that this part is stronger, because when you try to stretch out too much, this part is very weak and this part is very weak, so it has to be a little bit stronger. So either you use a torch or heat gun, or you just let it sit for maybe a couple hours so that the whole piece is stronger, and then you can stretch more. And when you stretch it, when it's dry, you stretch it, you can stretch it more. Okay, that's what I mean. All right, hope this helped. Okay, see you next time.